Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through traffic signals. So basically this concept, I think every one of you should teach me, right? Yes. So this is that much basic concept, guys. I hope everyone knows already about these traffic signals. So what is the main need or what is a traffic signal, guys, first of all? Okay, so traffic signals are the signals which are used to avoid the collisions. They'll be looking like this. We will be having three different colors. Okay, so they are used to reduce the chances of collisions or accidents, you can say. Okay, so these are also commonly used at intersections, guys, like where two or three roads are combining at the same point. So I will be drawing in this way. Okay, so here four roads are combining, right? Yes. So in this situation, traffic lights are really important, because to control them we cannot hire an police or a traffic police just to do that work, right? So it will be just his work, so it will be a hectic work, because in sun he should stand and he should do all those controlling, and that could be a tough task. So to avoid that, we will be using the traffic signals. Okay, at intersections, in order to avoid accidents and for orderly movement of traffic, so each and every vehicle will go in a particular order. So for this lane we'll be giving 20 seconds, after this we'll be giving for this 30 seconds, after this we'll be giving for 20, again 30. So in this way, in a particular order this will move, and even the vehicles will also follow this rule, because it is mandatory, right? So if there is a traffic signal, you should follow it, right? Yes. So need of signals. So what is the basic need of those signals? So they provide orderly movement of traffic, as I told you, of traffic, and increases the traffic handling capacity at junction. So if you ask me, which place controlling traffic is really tough? So at the junctions, guys, because four different routes. Okay, so here four different routes will combine, right? So in this situation, if a heavy vehicle comes from two lanes and if it slowly blocks the whole junction, that will be a huge issue, right? Yes. So controlling here the traffic is really a hectic thing. So using signals, we can do it with ease. Okay, so they reduce many accidents, especially right angled collisions. So right angled collisions are nothing but someone coming in this lane and someone coming from this lane or this lane. So the angle between them is 90 degrees, the collision. Okay, so like this, they will be hitting each other. Okay, yes. So those kind of collisions will be avoided because we are having signals. Simple, right? Yes. So pedestrians crossing and traveling from one side to another side will also be easy, as we are having proper signal. So basically, once this signal is off, like in a red, so someone who wants to go can go safely, right? Yes. So in this way, these signals will help the pedestrians also. Okay. So at signals, the police requirement will be reduced or removed directly, right? Yes. So remember that these should be automated, guys. So if those signals are manual, then the human or the policeman should be required. Okay, the disadvantages. So the disadvantages are rare end collisions will increase. So basically, if a vehicle is going at a high speed and on back of that vehicle, one more vehicle is coming at a high speed with the same speed. So those both are moving and suddenly the lights have been changed to red. So this guy successfully somehow managed to stop, but this guy didn't stop. He just hit him at the back. So this kind of collisions, like hitting one back other. So those are nothing but the rear end collisions, guys. Okay. Or this is an issue. Similarly, failure of signal. So basically you are having this signal from around 10 years, assume in that way. And there are many vehicles traveling without any issues from 10 years. Now suddenly this signal has damaged. So there is some issue and it is not working. So in this situation, the whole traffic which is commonly traveling is addicted for the type of signals, right? Yes. Whenever there is no signal, they will be confused whether they should go or he should go. And there will be a huge confusion and mess, and leads to a huge traffic, guys. So that is an issue. Similarly, delay to the traffic will occur. So basically, if it is completely automated, so assume that for this I gave 20 seconds, for this I gave 1 minute, for this I gave 20 seconds, for this I gave 30 seconds, okay? And there is no traffic in this lane, like there is no traffic, not even a single vehicle is there, but for this lane, as it is automated, every time it will be giving 1 minute. So is there any use? No. So in this, because of this 1 minute, these three lanes are just waiting. So this is an issue, guys. This is a disadvantage with the traffic signals, okay? Yes. So I hope everyone got a small idea on traffic signals. So in the next lecture, we'll be discussing about where to locate these signals, like illustration and location of signals. Okay. Yes. Okay, yes. So we'll be discussing about this illustration and location of signals in the next lecture. Okay, yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching.